a few months ago, I released Final Cut Pro Animator Scribbles, a plugin I built, allowing you to add hand-drawn animations to your Final Cut Pro projects. Today, I'm excited to release the Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles 1.1 update. This is a minor update, mainly focusing on bug fixes, but it does come with 5 brand new presets. Also, I was able to squash a major bug version 1.0 had. The Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles 1.1 is now fully compatible with wide gamut HDR libraries. If you previously bought Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles, you really don't need to watch this video. You should have received an email with step-by-step instructions on how to install the update. This is the first update for this plugin. I'm still figuring this out, but if you didn't receive the update email, skip to the end of this video and I'll show you a couple other ways you can update it. If you've never tried Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles, let me show you what this plugin is all about. First, installation. I've bought and tried all sorts of Final Cut Pro plugins, and the most common frustration I come across is installation. With most plugins, you either have to install the plugin manually or download separate installer software. I don't really care for either one of these methods, so I tried to make mine as user-friendly as possible. When you download Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles, you get an installer tool. To install this plugin, all you have to do is double-click on the installer tool and click Install. This is all you have to do. The installer tool does the rest for you. When done, you can go ahead and delete this tool or save it in case you need a clean install again. After installation, you'll find Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles in your Titles and Generators browser. Everything is organized into categories to make it easy to find exactly what you need. With this plugin, you get arrows, elements, shapes, numbers, symbols, and more. You also get the complete English alphabet, so you can make custom handwritten titles. Adding these to your project is super simple. You just pick the preset you want to add and drag and drop it into your timeline. All these come with a transparent background, so you don't need to worry about keying or messing around with blend modes to remove the background. Up in the viewer window, you get the basic controls to adjust your animation. You can move it around, resize it, and even rotate it. A lot of the time, these 3 controls might be all you need, but if you want to customize it even further, there are many more controls in the inspector window. At the top, you can change the color of your scribble and adjust the size, position, and rotation. This is the same controls as in the viewer window, just with a bit more precision. Under this, you can select this checkbox to add a drop shadow to your scribble. Selecting this checkbox turns on the 5 controls under it, allowing you to adjust the color of your drop shadow, opacity, blur, distance, and the angle of your shadows. Under the drop shadow controls, we get animation controls. By default, when you add a scribble to your project, you get a draw-in animation at the start and the same animation in reverse at the end. You can turn on or off each one of these individually with a build-in and build-out checkboxes. If you want your scribble to be even more dynamic, there's pulse and jitter checkboxes. Selecting pulse randomizes the X and the Y scale of your scribble independently for this pulsing effect. You can adjust the pulse amount with the amount slider, and you can change the pattern by refreshing the pulse pattern. Jitter does the same, but instead of adjusting the scale of your scribble, it randomizes position for a jitter effect. Same as pulse, you can adjust the amount of jitter or change the pattern by refreshing the jitter pattern. Most presets in this plugin come with the exact same controls, except for the animation category at the bottom. These are a little bit different. Down here, we have 2 types of animated presets. We have one-time animations, and these basically just animate on screen and fade out right after, and we have looping animations. What's different about these is you have no build-in and build-out options. All the other controls are exactly the same. And with looping animations, if you add one to your timeline and extend it out, it just keeps playing, no matter how long you make your clip. Next, I want to talk about the included alphabet and how you can use it to make animated, handwritten titles. It's actually super simple. Just take your first character, drop it down into your timeline, and move it over to the left side of the viewer window. Move your playhead to where the animation ends, add your next character, and place it beside the first one. Repeat this for the rest of your letters. When done, to make this easier to work with, select all your clips and make them into a compound clip with Option G. You can now move this clip around, retime it to speed it up, and more. And last, with the Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles 1.1 update, you get 5 new presets. This is just a small preview of what's coming in the 2.0 update, which I'm working on right now. It should be done in the next month or two, and just like the 1.1 update, it'll be completely free to anyone who's purchased this plugin before. The new presets include a new animated arrow, halo with wings, speech bubble, a dollar bill, and a thinking bubble. If you previously purchased Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles, you should see an email with a download link in your inbox. If you didn't get it, you can just sign into your account and download it there. If you have any issues with this update, just email me. I'll happily help you out. If you're new to Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles, for the next 7 days, this plugin, as well as all my other plugins, are on sale. Use the coupon code UPDATESALE to get 25% off all my plugins. I'll leave a link down in the video description. Thanks for watching, and thank you in advance for your support.